Boy, Mr. Rogers, it's certainly nice of you to invite me out to dinner tonight. This certainly is a nice place.
I only go out nice places, Smithers. I'll have you know that. That's right. You know, Smithers, it's not easy to run $100 million a year outfit. A lot of you could do a lot more to help, yes, sir. If you stop using those paper cuts, sell it to paper, and you could get a little bit more out of those pencils. And when you leave the office, turn out the lights at night, Smithers. Yes, sir. And remember this, Smithers.
Yes, sir.
This company is your company. You got to get emotionally involved.
Well, I certainly am trying to do my best, Mr. Rochester. It's a privilege to be working for you, sir. And I want to do my best because pretty soon there's going to be another mouth to feed in the family.
Oh, your wife going to have another baby?
No, sir. My mother-in-law's coming to live with us.
No, well, Smithers, I like a man with a sense of humor.
Thank you.
Too bad you don't have one. Little Reed, to run a $100 million corporation, you gotta have a sense of humor. Sense of humor.
I tell you, Mr. Rogers, you know what? I just sitting here just observing you. You remind me of that guy in Texas who was so rich he never watched anything but the $1 million movie.
You're pressing, Smithers. Now, Smithers, what I want you to do is get the check. That's right. Get the check. It'll teach you how to spend big and impress your boss.
How about that, the big windbag? He said he wanted to take me out to dinner. The only thing he's ever taken out is his teeth. Look at him, the human tank. No, I'm wrong. You can fill a tank.
Put another one over on the poor idiot. Wanted to invite me to his house for dinner. Oh, boy, what a house. You think he'd find something better with that $63 a week I pay him? I bet the termites don't even have to bite into the wood. They just let their teeth chatter and lean forward.
I've got to get that raise. If I don't get that raise from him tonight, I've got something else up my sleeve. A knife. That's what I got up there.
They told me he was after a raise. Oh, he's quite a guy. He started at the bottom and stayed there. I'm glad I conned him into this restaurant. Couldn't have stood going over to his house. Last time I was there, I saw green grass coming up through the living room floor.
What does he expect for $40 a month? Roses?
He shouldn't be asking for more money. A raise! After all, what good is money? Can it buy you health? Can it buy you love?
Of course he's talking about Confederate money. I've got a good mind to quit. I don't need him. I got an independent income. Unemployment insurance.
Oh, Smithers, nothing like a good Havana after a good meal there.
Yes, sir.
Young man, you're slow, Smithers, you're slow. Hey.
Yes, Mr. Smithers?
Isn't that Tab Hunter over there?
Oh, yeah, it is. That's my friend Tab Hunter?
Wow! Hey, you know, my daughters are crazy about him. If they knew that I was in the same room with Tab Hunter, they'd go crazy. Oh, I'd love to get his autograph.
Well, Tab and I are old friends.
What?
Yes, we're old friends. I just haven't bothered him. I didn't even see him over there.
Wait a minute. Let me get this straight.
What?
Smithers, you mean to say that Tab Hunter and you are good friends?
Oh, yes. He calls me Arnold. I call him Tab.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Well, then, boy, bring him over here. What are we waiting for? Bring him over. Show some initiative.
Bring him over here.
That's right. Go on. Don't be a milquetoast, or your life.
Bring. Tap, 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 tap.
That's right. Bring bring Tabhunter over here.
Yes.
Come on, boys. Snap to it. You'll never get any place in life if you don't snap to it.
Mr. Hunter, sir, you don't know me. I'm Arnold Smithers, and we were in the Navy together. Only we didn't meet because you were in the Atlantic and I was in the Pacific. So and I tell you, I'm with my boss tonight, see, and his kids are big fans of yours, and I know I was reading, and I told him I was a friend of yours, that we were personal friends. That you call me Arnold, and I called you. I call you Tab, and it would mean so much to me if you would stop over and say hello to me. It would impress him so much, Hunter, sir. I know I read in town that you're in here doing a promotion for your picture, Birds Do It, from Columbia, and I certainly am going to be there to see it, but it would mean so much to me if you could come over and just say, hi, Arnold, you know, or something. It would impress. I have a wife and children I need to raise.
Well, would you like me to give them just a little autograph or something like that from your dad or your wife?
Well,
sir,
if you would just say hello, if you'd come over, it would impress him because I'm trying to get this raise, sir, and it means so much to me. Would you please, sir, please, I certainly enjoyed you in The Sword of the Adventure.
Arnold Smith.
You're all right, Mr. Hunter. He said when he finished his coffee, he'd stop over. We haven't seen each other in a long time, and just like that, he said, hi there, Arnold, you know, and I told him that you had to come. Now, Mr. Rogers, about the raise, see,
hey, Arnold, how are you?
Beat it, Tab, can't you see I'm busy? I hope everybody's feeling good today. And Ben, it's nice to have you back in case you missed yesterday. Ben Gady's back from Florida. And, of course, that's where we did the picture, Birds Do It, and the Tab and the whole thing. Oh, and Claudia Gilbert and Karen Rice, they got some pictures and they made up some captions for it. Now, here's a picture of me doing the mouth. Look at it. And pan down. The number to call in New York is Bigelow. 20999. And I didn't win. Okay, here's another one right here. And the caption is, get off my back, Ma. I'm a big boy now, and I don't want any chicken soup. That's my mother. Well, you've got possibilities, but you'll have to get this fixed. Stay with me, folks. Look at that fool blowing bubble gum when I'm getting a publicity shot. Is this really necessary for a pair of pants? Okay. Fungus, you say? Do you think it's catching? There's one down here. Boy, that was some part. Okay. This one. All right. No kidding. Whenever there's a full moon, eh? Right here. Oh, that's my beloved right there. Do you think blondes really have more fun? there it is. And Ed is saying here. Am I doing it right? No, Ed, not in the ears. Fast.
Okay, let's... Here's Leonard, Frank. Let's see. Here is Dick. Here is Sally. Look at Dick Run. Look at Sally Run. And this is Sal, would you get the pacifier out of Bert's mouth, change him, and put him up on the camera?
And that's our group, Ben. And, of course, a lot of things have been...
What are you doing?
Hi, good buddy.
Hi, Fluke. How are you? Say hello.
Hi. Just call me Tab.
You're Tab.
That's right. I'm Tab Hunter.
You're putting me on. Tab Hunter happens to be tall, and he's blonde, and good-looking, wavy hair.
Speaking! No, Tab Hunter and I are one and the same people, Booby.
You mean you and Tab are the same people?
That's right.
I don't believe that.
Well, you've never seen us in a picture together, have you?
No, that's right, I haven't. I didn't know that he and Tab were the same.
Oh, sure.
Tab does lines better than you do, but that's all right.
Listen. Well,
yeah?
Listen, I'm very popular in pictures. Well, here's a picture that made me famous.
Yeah? Yeah, that's the ones in the post office. The price has gone up. There's a price on your head.
There is?
Yes, it's $3.98 right here.
It has gone up.
Yeah. So you're in the pictures, huh?
Oh, yes. Yeah. I'm very busy. You know, in fact, any minute now, I'm expecting a call from Hollywood.
Oh, yeah? Damn it, Paul. Hello? Yeah, he's here. It's the call for you.
Who voice?
Yeah. Paramount? Book? Short? Oh, yeah? All right, I'll tell him. He left your shorts at the Paramount.
Well, let me win if you lose if you have.
Yeah, that's it. Well, where are you going now?
I'm going with you.
Okay, let's go over to the Words of Wisdom, okay? That's right, they're very important today, and we want you to pay close attention to them, and they go like this. Show me England being invaded by toads, and I'll show you a froggy day in London town. Now, just what do we mean by that?
Yeah, what do we mean by that?
Well, you tell them, Boo. You take over. Go ahead. Tell them. Tell them. Show me England being invaded by toads, and I'll show you a foggy day in London town. Go ahead.
Oh, help me, Booby.
Right.
Help me.
All right. Okay, just calm down. Calm.
Wait, I'll try.
Yeah.
I'll try.
All right.
Well.
Yeah.
You see?
Yeah.
There was once this frog who had a man in his throat.
A frog had a man in his throat?
That's right.
Yeah.
And he went to the doctor and he told him, you better get the warts out. Oh, Booby, I'm in trouble.
The warts out?
That's right.
Yeah.
On the other hand, I have five fingers. But you see, it's not a question of whether it is or it isn't, but must you if you have to when you don't have it?
I understand.
Keep me covered.
Oh, you'll be all right. No, the thing is, it's like if you shouldn't have sore throat, you know, and that you have to keep, you know, your neck bundle up in the cold weather. Because if you go to the doctor and usually go have your throat painted, I mean, if you got a lot of money, you can have it wallpapered. That's what I'm saying. But the thing is, what do we mean by that? That's right. Watch out for invading toads.
That's right.
That's it.
Well, Booby,
that's right.
I got to be going now.
Yeah. Well, wait a minute. I just want to impress upon you about you should always be happy and be, you know, there are times when you feel blue and you don't have any happiness to fill your cup, and you shouldn't let a little thing like that bother you.
Well, no, but I was going to go to see Leona.
You let me finish the song, or you're never going to see Leona.
may be times when you're feeling blue. No happiness to fill your cup. Just hold your head high, whatever you do. And don't ever, no, never give up. There may be times when you're feeling low and nothing goes right somehow. To reach your own star is a long trip, you know. So you'd better get started right now.
And it's great. Step right up and get this raisin bread. Oh, you eat a slice of this raisin bread, and it leaves a lump in your stomach. I tell you, it's like Mom used to bake before she was drafted. Yes, sir. It's really authentic raisin bread. It's just crammed full of great raisins. I'll just show you, when I have a raisin bread sale, people from miles around come to buy my raisin bread. I'll just show you, right? Watch. I got raisin bread for sale! Here's a loaf of raisin bread for you. For you. Here you go. Here you go. You like that? Like that. Yeah. That's good. That's good. See, that just goes to show you how great the raisin bread is. You'll certainly want to take a loaf home. Yeah. $1. Yeah. Okie doke. You want to wrap it up? Well, you'll eat it here. Okay. Step right up. And I want you to get that raisin. What? Wait, what? You found a fly in a raisin bag? Well, you bring back the fly, I'll give you another raisin.
I wonder where Bubba is.
Well, where did he go?
Oh!
What is it?
Hi, Bubba. Oh, I hate to disturb you, Bubba, but could I have my allowance?
What are you going to do with the money?
Well, Bubby, I've got a big date with Leona.
I thought you and Leona broke up.
Well, we did, but we made up. I'll tell you, she's really in love with me, Bubby.
How do you know?
Well, you know, the other night?
Yeah.
Well, she beat on my door for 3 hours, but I wouldn't open it.
She beat on your door for 3 hours and you wouldn't open it?
That's right.
Why not?
What? And let her out of the closet? Thank you, Bubby.
Okay. Hello?
Hello, is this Soupy Sales?
Yes, it is.
Are you sure it's Soupy Sales?
Yeah, I'm sure it's Soupy Sales.
You positive it's Soupy Sales?
Yes, I'm positive it's Soupy Sales.
You wouldn't kid me now.
No, I wouldn't kid you.
You're Soupy Sales?
Yes, I'm Soupy Sales.
The Soupy Sales is on television?
Yeah, the one, Soupy Sales is on television.
And it's really you speaking?
Yeah, it's really me speaking.
You're not some other Soupy Sales.
No, I'm not any other Soupy Sales.
You're the one who lives in the house with white bag and black tooth and you do the mouse and everything?
I'm the one that lives in the house with black tooth and the mouse and do the white fang. I live in the house with white fang and do the mouse.
So you're really Soupy Sales?
Yes, I'm really Soupy Sales. What is it, sir? What can I do for you?
This is Charlie Cook. I want the $5 you borrowed from me.
I'll give Soupy the message when he comes in. Thanks for being with us. Bye-bye.